What do you do if you're if you had enough and you can't live with your husband because you feel like he does nothing for you?
Okay.
He does not like spending time with you. He does not know anything about you or your family situation. He does not teach you anything. He's in his own life. Can you get someone involved?
Okay. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I'll answer very shortly, but this will be answered the next week, inshallah ta'ala, in depth. If, as we said, nothing works out between these two couples, and they have tried all means of getting together, and as I said, love is the basis of a marriage. If there is no masha'ir, if there's no feelings between the two couples, then the house will become, as we said, the Cold War. The husband will say my rights, the wife will say my rights. It becomes a lawyer. You are arguing, where's my rights? Duties. No, these rights and these duties, if there is love and feelings between the two couples, many things can be sorted out. So if there is no love between the two persons, the best solution is divorce. There's no point pushing these two couples together. But before that, as we said, you need to try to work it out. You need to find out if you have feelings towards each other. And sometimes don't be fooled with sometimes the reaction of your husband. Sometimes he might be doing things that might hurt, that makes you upset. But that's to find out, does he love you deep in his heart or not? So inshallah ta'ala, this question will be answered in depth in next week regarding how to resolve matters such as this between the two couples, inshallah ta'ala. But if things don't work out, as we said, it's better to have divorce between the two couples, because if the house there's not love between the two couples, nothing will work out. Nothing will work out, full stop. You're going nowhere. So inshallah ta'ala, this is my answer. Wa sallallahu sallam ala nabina Muhammad alayhi wa sallam.
Any questions from the Lord?
Before divorce, let's say you have a dilemma with your wife, but before resorting to divorce, I heard that you can beat your wife lightly. What does lightly mean?
Khair, inshallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The brother asked, in the process of resolving your dilemma or your problem with your wife, is it allowed for a man to beat his wife lightly? Yes and no. Why I say yes, the Sharia allows the husband to beat his wife if she exceeds the limits of advice and nasiha, and the issue of al-hajr. Al-hajr is to turn your face away from her in the bed. So you don't talk to her, you don't speak to her, you don't eat the food that she cooks. Some women, this is more stronger than a punch or a bullet. For some women, they will not last one night. If brothers have such wives, you need to say Alhamdulillah. It's a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, such a wife. Even if she makes you the second night upset, it doesn't matter. Every night she makes you upset. As long as she's the type of woman that will always not sleep at night unless you are pleased with her, because she understands this importance, fahmadillah ala dhalik. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this ni'mah. So inshallah ta'ala, you need to try all the other means, such as nasiha, the advice. Then you need to try the issue of a hijab to avoid her, boycott her in the bed. If she doesn't listen, then you make hijab in the sleep next room, you avoid her. For some women, it doesn't make sense. So you tell to your sheikh, go to the next room, why are you sleeping in this bed? She will kick you herself. And you can be away for 2 months and 3 months and she doesn't care. Some women are like that. The solution is now to bring the family into view. I do not advise hit a woman. Completely, even lightly. Because when you hit her with lightly, which is miswak, what happens? She's going to hit you back. Or she's going to scratch you. Defense, self-defense. What are you going to do then? You're going to continue with this miswak? You won't continue with the miswak. You move into your martial arts that Allah taught you. You have to. It happens. It leads into. You touch a woman, she will defend herself back automatically. At least she will push you. And you'll get upset and shaitan is there. I do not advise touching women. I do not advise. Completely ولا مسواك ولا nothing. I do not advise completely. Especially if women know self-defense lessons. Don't even play with these powers. Do not, if things don't work out, divorce is better. I prefer divorce than hitting a woman and then sleeping with her after a week. No, do not touch women, do not hit them, don't you ever prey your muscles on women. You're tough, go look for a fight. Your wife gets you upset, you want to fight, that's the only way you can calm down, go out on the street, look for a fight. Don't do anything in your house. Even if it means that you have to leave her for a while until she calms down, she will learn a lesson. If she's a type of woman that we mentioned, she don't learn no lesson from this, then, as we said, divorce this type of woman. I remember my brother who asked me for such advice. Very sincere brother, I loved him for the sake of Allah. Very sweet brother. He said, my wife does not learn unless I hit her. And I said, what's her reaction? He said, she hits me back and we fight. And we fight. I said to her, Akhi, do not do this. You're not a man. Because I mentioned this in a lecture and he was sitting in a lecture, so he got affected. He said, how come he's saying you don't hit your woman? So he asked me in privacy. He said to me, this is what happens between me and my wife. I said, don't touch your woman, Akhi. Do not hit your wife. Impossible. He said, then what can I do? I said, divorce her. He said, but I love her. I said, keep loving each other, class. But don't touch your woman. Don't touch, inshallah.
Exactly.
So don't ever go near that one, inshallah. Barakallah.
Sister asks a question, what could you do to overcome the fear of getting married?
The fear. I hope I haven't turned away many sisters from marriage. I hope I haven't done that because it's also, as I said, it's dangerous. Consequences. Inshallah ta'ala, as we said, my sisters, inshallah ta'ala, the only way is to look for a brother that pleases you. Don't get fooled by looks, don't get fooled by how much Bukhari he memorizes. Don't fool by Sahih al-Muslim that he memorizes. Look for two characteristics. Look for his akhlaq and look for his deen. إِذَا أَتَاكُمْ أَرْتَضَّوْنَ خُلُوقَهُ وَدِينَهُ فَزَوِجُهُ. His akhlaq and his deen. So inshallah ta'ala, even if it takes 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, 9 months, 10 months, I don't care how long it takes, get to know the brother until you are pleased with him. Do not get involved in such a marriage. I don't care how long it takes. You need to know this person because some people can outplay. They can play the role. Yeah? They want to talk to the sister, he can play the role. So you need to find out about his history. Know the person, inshallah ta'ala. And as I said, make istikhara. Make istikhara to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you. If you are seriously want to marry, make istikhara, as I said, every week or every day once. If you are very serious in the matters of marriage, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the faraj, the iman that will please you, inshallah ta'ala, and that will make you to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakallahu khair.
Brother asks, assalamu alaikum, Shaykh. I'm very angry because my wife keeps requesting divorce. Wallahi, I feel like doing it, but something is holding me back. When I think deep, I love her, but she is saying words that anger me so much. I'm not perfect, I'm not the best husband, but she just moans, doesn't really help. So please advise me what to do.
Okay. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. An Thawban qala, narrated by a Sahabi by the name of Thawban radiallahu anhu, qala, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أيما امرأة سألت زوجها الطلاق من غير بأس فحرام